In this video, we will show you how to export a mix or a file to a specific file format, such as MP3, M4A, MP4, WAV, WMA, WMV, etc. In the mixing screen, I have an audio and video mix open on separate tabs. Firstly, I'll open the audio mix. If I want to export this mix to a file format such as MP3, I simply click on the Export Mix button in the mixing screen. When I click this button, the Save Media To dialog box appears. Firstly, I can select a destination where I want the exported file to be saved to. And then I can give my mix a file name. Once done, I will select the file type for this mix. I have numerous choices, such as WAV, MP3, M4A, WMA, AUG, and FLAC. Here I'll select MP3. In the audio codec drop-down menu, I can choose the quality with which the MP3 will be saved in. Here I'll select 128 kbps, which is CD quality. I can also give tags to the MP3 file, such as author, title, artist, genre, and any comments you may wish to add. When I click Save, my mix will be exported as an MP3 file. And will be presented in the media browser. You can use this file to upload to the internet, burn to CD, import to your iPod or other media players, or simply share with friends. So now I'll open up the video mix. Firstly, and most importantly, I'd like to draw your attention to the target frame size when editing video in the mixing screen. Ideally, you will firstly select the target frame, as this will dictate where the borders and frame dimensions will be set for your exported file. For example, if I want to make a video for YouTube, I can click on the target frame size and select YouTube HQ, High Quality. Your video will now be displayed in the video output screen and YouTube with the correct aspect ratio. You will also notice that some frame sizes are shown in bold. These selections, shown in bold, require specific encoding parameters and templates that are known to work for these selections. An important note, if you create a mix in a target frame size and thereafter change the target frame size to a different aspect ratio, the relative position of your files in relation to each other as viewed in the output screen may change. Once you've chosen your target frame size and are happy with your mix, click on the Export button in the mixing screen. Again, the Save Media To dialog box will appear. Select a destination where you'd like your file to be saved to, and give the file a name. As I've selected YouTube HQ in the target frame size, the audio and video codecs, as well as the frame size, are preset, as these parameters are known to work. Again, I can add tags such as author, title, artist, genre, and add any comments I may wish to add. When happy, click Save, and my file will be exported and presented again in the media browser. If I choose a target frame size that is not in bold and click Export, you'll notice that all the drop-down menus are live, allowing me to choose different file formats, audio and video codecs, and frame size. So I'll select a destination and I'll give my file a name. In the Save As type box, I can choose a file format such as AVI, MP4, or WMV. Just a word of note, AVI files are uncompressed and can produce a very large file. However, here I'll select MP4. In the audio codec drop-down box, I can choose the quality of the audio. Here I'll select AAC 320 kbps, which is the highest quality. In the video codec drop-down box, I have a choice between either exporting to MPEG-4 or H.264. These are both MP4s, but H.264 will produce a higher quality file, but will take longer to encode. In the drop-down box, you can also choose different levels of quality, level 1 being the lowest, and level 5 being the highest. Here I'll select H.264 level 3. In the frames per second drop-down box, you can choose the frame rate of the file. Again, the higher the frame rate, the better the quality, but the file will take longer to encode and will produce a larger file. The frame size will be defaulted to the target frame size you've chosen in the mixing screen. As mentioned previously, if you change the frame size in this drop-down box, the relative position of your files in relation to each other as viewed in the output screen may change. Again, you can add tags to your file. Click Save and your mix will be exported. The exporting mix window will appear and present the details and the progress. You can pause and cancel an export at any time. You can also export multiple files at the same time. When exported, your file will be presented in the media browser. In the media browser, you can right-click on the file and select Upload to YouTube. You can also use this file to burn to DVD, upload to other websites, or email and share with family and friends. Word of note, in the mixing screen, if you've created a selection box by holding down the Shift key and the left button on your mouse, or have created a loop region, the exported file will only contain the media in these areas. Also, if you have media muted, they will not be exported. If you have a track or track soloed, only these tracks will be contained in the exported file. If you already have a file in a specific file format and would like to convert it quickly so that it can play on media players such as iPhone, iPad, or PSP, you can right-click on it and select Convert, or double-click on it to bring it into the track cutter. When in the track cutter, I can export the file, or an edit selection, or a loop region if created, by clicking on the Export button. Once you've clicked the Export button, you can save the file as mentioned previously. Finally, if you have a video mix or a photo slideshow created in the mixing screen and the target frame size is set to one of the YouTube presets, you can click on the YouTube button to export and directly upload your file to YouTube. To learn more, please see the Upload to YouTube video.